Hello guys, it's Peter and Eddie from PS Sound, and this is going to be a longish video, so yeah, get your popcorn out, because we are going to show you the latest edition of this BMW 6 GT. You could see many videos of it as it started last November, when we did the first part of the installation. And even last time when I had the last video, we were saying that this might be the end of this project, and then here we are again. It was back for more changes. So let's run through what we've done. The biggest addition to this part of the installation was getting that Adair Brahma 12-inch sub in, because before we had a JL13W7 down there underneath the floor, because the owner wanted a practical trunk and wanted to keep everything underneath the floor. But this time he has a bit more flexibility and he said that he would rather want something in there. So what we did with Eddie, yeah, you had a good time with it, didn't you?
Yep.
A few days. It probably took a hard week to get this built, because we had to clear a lot of stuff out. We had to take that plastic panel out, which went further. We had to take brackets out, little studs, whatnot, to get as much space as we could. You mossed everything out, and we used the usual puzzle technique for the backing of this custom sealed enclosure,
which was painful.
It was definitely not an easy one, but we managed to squeeze out
30 liters, 29, 28, 29, 30.
Yeah, I will drop in short footage of the video when
when
we filled it up. The guys will see it later on in this video when we did the usual water test, so we could check the volume as well as any leakage. But you will see it shortly. But yeah, it's definitely a beautifully practical car, because just with a flick of a button, those seats drop down. So this car is built onto the platform of the 7 Series, but of course the 7 Series doesn't have this practicality. This trunk is huge on its own, then you have all that flat floor space. You can literally put in the fridge. Which is,
you can sleep in it.
Yeah, you can easily sleep in it. It's easily 2 meters this way, I think, to the front seats. And yeah, up front, not much changed. I'm gonna walk to the front and then show to you what we changed. But we have three-way up front with front sub, and we also use the factory rear fill as differential rear fill. And then Eddie has taken the custom grill off that we made that slots in into this gap all around the sub, because yeah, we had to play with the tolerances. The sub had to come out pretty much all the way to get clearance for the magnet, as it's a pretty deep sub. So we kept the enclosure in line with the side of the trunk, but as you can see, the rubber surround is so big that it has just enough clearance for the floor. If we lift up the floor, then it just passes it with few millimeters. So that's why certain things can take longer, because you really have to play with all the tolerances. And this was the only solution with the removable grill to open this up to get to the amps and the DSP. We also built one of these little storage spaces. Can you pop it out, Eddie? Because some people may not remember what's underneath it, but as easy as that, the factory battery is right underneath there. Power distribution for all the amps. So we have 2 6 channel Zepco 150.6 AP amps. So those run the front mid tweet and the rear fill, and the other one runs the front sub bridged, because it's dual voice call, 4 ohm each coil. So we have 2 channels bridged for each voice call. In theory, now we have 1 kilowatt headroom for that Focal 10, which is a bit crazy, but we had those channels freeing up, so that was the best thing to use for, because we don't need bridge power for the mid bass. They have so much sensitivity and output now through the floor, you could see in the previous video. And that's the last 2 channel for the mid bass from the 6 channels. And we had to add this 400.2 AP bridged for the Brahma. So we have more than 1.2, nearly 1.3 kilowatt for that 12 inch sub. Yeah, people are very interested what I think about it, what we think about this sub. It's definitely a beautiful sounding 12-inch driver in sealed box. No mechanical noise, it's so clean. Yes, it requires a bit of power to make it come alive, but considering it's only 1 cubic foot sealed box, it drops really low. It plays really low, that easy to integrate, it blends in. I can't really say anything bad about it other than it's a box. Because I said it a million times that what a sub is like in a car is not just what subwoofer you use, it's the location, the application, how you can integrate it to the acoustical characteristics of the cabin. So overall it's great, it's definitely a big improvement over the flat JL, which was a big, big limitation, which did a good job to be fair, because no other sub could really squeeze in into such a shallow box that we built here before. So this is now a better solution for the front end. So we only have to get now a factory panel because we had to modify it, and then it will look definitely way better. I just walked to the front because I don't think that some of you remember the front end. So we have the Focal TBM, the Utopia M range three-way up front, the TBM tweeter in custom sail panels. Then we have the 3.5 mids in the pillars. The 8-inch driver is underneath the seats. I'm gonna drop a link to the playlist of this build and you can see what we've done with that. But I'm gonna talk about that shortly, what we were testing last week with that mid-base solution. And then we have the Focal Utopia M 10-inch sub in sealed up front. There's a video of that. I'm not going to talk about it now, why we needed that up front, why we needed that to integrate the mid-bass to the rear sub to get the best solution in this car. The bass in this car is completely seamless and it's up on the top of the dash. You can't really locate anything, no resonances. And yeah, that was a big job as well. That took me a week as well, same way. Fully custom built, fiberglass at the back, really thick baffle. And people always cry about, you know, what happens, someone is going to just step on it. Well, those bars definitely give support, because when the factory carpet comes back in, that's so supportive and thick that sits in front of it and it's perfectly fine. If you wanted something fancier, then you could have a custom CNC machined aluminium grill or something. There are many things you could do. It's all down to time and budget most of the times. And we may have something in the future, something fancier looking, but for now it's perfectly functional and safe and wants to be fed. That is back on. You can't even tell that there's a subwoofer there. And it doesn't even take too much away from the leg room because I cut out all the carpet and we gained nearly 4 inches that way towards the firewall. So yeah, it just works. So this car, we can say it's OEM plus because it's not shouty, it's not too much in the face. And then actually, as any other BMW, it goes to sleep after a while. Once you sit in, it blends in nicely. And we have full integration through MOST 25. I can control volume tracks. If I scroll down, hopefully you can see, yep, the playlist appears on the head-up display. You just scroll, press next song, that easy to navigate the songs. That's it, so you can see it. It's so easy to live with. And then volume up and down.
Never know how much I love you, never know how much I care. Love to have your arms around me, I get a fever that's so hard to bear. You give me fever with your kisses, fever when you hold me tight. Fever in the morning, fever all through the night. Thank you.
bass heavy song.
Sun lights up the daytime.
Let's go to that one.
A woman, not too young, not too old, just right, right in the middle, just about right in the middle. And then, well, when I guess I'll get a little older, God willing, guess I'll just get a wee bit older, and then I'll be yes. That's right, and older woman. Mm-hmm. And as the years roll on and on and on, I keep on getting older. God,
little funny things in life. I have to let that fly go out because it drives me nuts. I don't even know how we get a fly in here. Well, it's summer in UK right now, so. Not impossible. Come on, fly. Eddie, can you please open passenger side though?
Well, I guess nothing for it.
You see, this is life. There you go, fly went out. Thank you, that was it. You can shut it back. We had a fly and it was flying all over the place. It was quite funny. So what I have to talk about, why the car was here, other than just the rear sub change. When we did the True IB mid-bass installation underneath the seat, we definitely transformed the system. All the rattles, buzzes or anything we had, because the underseat bass drivers breathe into the side seal of the car, everything comes alive and rattles. In some BMWs it's okay, you can live with it, but in this one it was pretty bad. And when you don't only hear the sound, but you hear buzzes and rattles, that can kill all the enjoyment. No matter how much you spent on equipment, it's just not going to happen. So I told to the owner that the driver, the 4Cal 8-inch driver, had perfect specs for True IB. And it is a sacrifice to cut the car. You can see in the video, in the playlist I put into the description, you can check how that was done. But basically, it breathes through the floor. We have protection underneath it, and then the under tray, plastic under tray of the car, so when this car goes to the garage, no one can actually tell that we cut the floor. We have a nearly 5-inch hole through the floor underneath the driver, and it can be turned back to factory without any problem. No one is going to see once it's put back, welded back, and then deadening over it. It's going to be absolutely fine. However, I don't think many people would worry about it, because there's no road noise coming in through that. It's a misconception. In many cases, some people say, oh, I can hear so much road noise, so much more road noise now because that hole was cut. But in reality, now I had the chance to drive this car in the last few days to test it on the road as well, and there's nothing coming through. It's pretty much the same example as, like, you have your window open, just a crack, just a tiny little bit. You have all the noise coming in. As soon as you shut it, you don't hear anything. And how thick is that gloss? It's not really thick. It's not a soundproof gloss. And same way, the driver is thin, but once it goes in, into place, bolted in, then you have the grill above it, underneath it, then the under tray, there's no noise coming in. Actually, this car is so quiet on the road. We spent 6 days soundproofing everything in it. You can see from previous videos, the wheel arches were soundproofed, all the doors, the whole trunk and everything. So even the factory car wasn't loud on the road. But now with all the extra work, it's so quiet. You can't hear the engine, even if it's in sport mode and it's a 3-liter bi-turbo, pretty sporty engine. You can't hear the exhaust or the engine at all. So it's a beautiful environment for long drives, cruising along and enjoying music in the best quality. But I drifted away. So basically when we did the True IB mid bass, the customer was saying that even if he's over the moon with it, all of us were, and we are, but the neighbors were not. He lives on a really busy road where the car is parked on the street close to the house, and then it's a terrace street, so if he wants to go out late night and listen to music even on low level, before it wasn't an issue because the drivers were breathing into the chassis rail and there wasn't that much mid bass on the outside of the car. Yes, if you turn it up you can hear it even that way, or if you have a mid bass in a door in a normal car you can hear that mid bassy rhythm outside, or if someone has a phone call in a factory car without any soundproofing you can hear pretty much all the conversation outside. So he said that he would rather allow me to test if we could find a solution not to lose the quality of the mid bass but limit the sound that goes to the outside, because the mid bass was pretty much as loud outside as inside. When you drive along it doesn't matter, but yes, late night if you really want to go out and enjoy it, people would say, you know, why don't you drive away, or why do you go out that late night? But it's one of those things that when you have a space like this and freedom away from the family and everyone, you just want peace and quiet, just sit back and enjoy music even at low levels. It's very relaxing, and that's why audiophiles spend so much money on audio systems at home or in a car, because they want to enjoy music in the best quality whenever and wherever they can. So we spent several days swapping out the Focal, because that's not optimal for a periodic AP application. So we tried the old Accutone driver I had from Arco, because that has very good specs for AP application, and I modified the mounting, mounted the Accutone in it, dropped it in, and we did several tests with the filter underneath it on the outside, how it limits the airflow and how it affects the response and what we can get out of it. It wasn't bad. I could have tuned a pretty good car out of that solution too, but it wasn't as good as with the Focal in True IB. The Focal in True IB in this car just gave such a snappy punch and kick, so controlled, there's no overhang, there's nothing affecting the driver's movement, and as the specification of the driver is ideal for that application, because most Focal drivers need a lot of airspace, because they most people would put it in the door where you have a lot of airspace inside of the door. And then with True IB we have all of it. So the driver just works so freely, so clean. And from the previous video you can see the measurements as well, how it transformed everything. And at the end we had to get to the conclusion that we don't want to sacrifice that. We rather have to sacrifice, he has to sacrifice on keeping his neighbors happy. So we turned everything back. Yes, we wasted several days. In most people's mind it would be waste, but actually what happened that we gained experience and we stopped a sort of a thinking in his mind that what if, that question what if cannot be coming up again, because we sorted it. There's no better option for this car or many cars than True IB mid bass if someone wants the cleanest, most accurate mid bass or bass. Yes, it comes with a sacrifice, I've said it many times, but hey ho, we live once, why wouldn't we enjoy it? So again, I'm frightened to say that this system is complete, because that's what I said the last time, and then here we are. We spent more than a week and a half doing the rear sub, installing new amplifier, making a custom press grill, playing with the mid bass, and then little adjustments, tuning and all that. So yes, this is definitely an extreme level OEM plus star build. I got a message the other day from someone and they were asking me about what I thought about the 4K Utopias. They are great drivers, no question about it. Some people think it's too expensive, some people think it's well priced or too cheap. It is what it is, it's priced where it is. But one suggestion to everyone who thinks about having these drivers. You think that in UK it costs 3 grand with the 8-inch mid-bass, and then you budget for that. In order to get a system that really supplies everything, the amplification, the wiring and the installation, to get the best out of these drivers, you know, you need a proper budget. And it may shock you, but you need at least 15 grand, minimum 15 grand, if not 20 grand, to get a system. A system. That's what people have to focus on. So these may only cost 3K, but to the time it's all well installed, all the labor and material and everything go into the setup, it's going to be big money. From the price of those three-way system, we built the electric van I shared on YouTube a few weeks ago. So it's all relative, and you can still get great results without super expensive speakers. I'm not saying that, you know, not to have these drivers. If you are ready and you have the budget, go for it. You won't be disappointed. It's definitely not harsh. People used to say utopias are harsh. It's nowhere the case. Yes, the previous model was a bit more difficult to tune right, and it could be way too bright. This Utopia M is not even close to it. It's nicely detailed, it's natural on the top end, even with these beryllium tweeters, and there's no harshness in it at all. If it's harsh for you, then I'm telling you, and I can put my head on it, that you have a bad install and you have a really bad tune. That's all it takes. You can ruin even good equipment and good speakers with just poor installation and bad tuning. Overall, yes, now we have four-way or Fokker Utopia up front, plus the Adair at the back. It's definitely something that I advise to people to hear. And if you want to hear this car, then I can arrange it. I'm sure the owner is happy to show it to the right people who are truly interested to get something like this. Or if we have meetings, then we may try to pull him over, and then you can hear this setup. But yeah, just get ready that this is a lot of time. I think we have around 40 days installation time in this car so far, and a fair amount of money. So yeah, but this is how special systems are born. We'll be right back. legit, but it actually works. Guys, don't take it as a reference, it's still a phone recording, but at least it gives you a bit of inspiration, an idea about why we do all this, and I can only encourage you to pop down, have a chat with us if you plan a big system, have a demo. We have several cars around all the time that you can listen to. You can get an idea about what this sound quality madness is, what it's like when you can hear and not just hear, but you can see a staging in front of you. You can get a holographic image and you can see the band and the instruments and all the members of the band right in front of you. If this is all new to you, come down, have a chat, and don't even think about spending any money without that, or find a meeting where you can hear well set up sound quality systems. So here we are, this is another part of this project. We will see what happens in the future, let me know what you think about it. Feel free to comment as always and subscribe to the channel if you're not subscribed, because some of you know exactly that sometimes we do crazy stuff that you don't really see anywhere else. So this is it for this one, and hopefully I can see you in the next video. Take care. Welcome to the world.